गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ मिली साखला एंड टूडे वी अगेन इन सब्जेक्ट स्ट्रक्चर एनालिसिस पार्ट वन वी डिस्कस अवर टॉपिक डायरेक्ट एंड बेंडिंग स्ट्रेस एंड टूडे सेशन वी अगेन डिस्कस अबाउट अवर थियोरी पोर्शंस. ओके, नाउ इन टूडे सेशन वी डिस्कस द थियोरी फॉर डैम एंड रिटेनिंग वॉल. नाउ हियर आई ड्रॉ द साइड सेक्शन ऑफ डैम एंड दिस इज द थ्री फिगर ऑफ डैम. First one is plan of this dam. Look at this. This is the 1, 2 and 3 section are given. Okay, 1, 2, 3. This is our plan. In front of view, this is our elevation point of view and this is our general view. Okay, now here we can see that this pier section is given and from this back position, water is storage. Now, what is the main purpose of dam? Main purpose of dam is to store the water. And the main purpose of retaining wall to store the soil. Okay, now this is our first figure of plan. In this first figure of plan, we can see that here the line out of dam. Okay, and this is general view of our dam. Now here I take one side section of pier section. Okay, one side section of dam or retaining wall. One by one I explain you. This is the section. This is a self weight of dam and this load is acting in downward direction and this sign is indicate water pressure sign. Okay, now in this back sign, this is the water storage of dam. Okay, and this sign is given a water level sign. Okay, this is this triangle, inverted triangle is the water storage of water storage sign. Now this small h is equal to height of dam and this capital H is equal to this small h is equal to height of water level and this capital H is equal to height of dam. This is A is equal to our top width of dam, B is equal to our bottom width of dam and this front side of this dam is known as toe level and this back side where water is storage, it is known as our hill level. Okay, now later on again we learn this in depth. This is again our side view of or what we say side section of pier or dam section or retaining wall. Okay, one by one here I written down the full form of all terms. A is equal to top width of dam, B is equal to bottom width of dam, H is equal to height of dam, small h is equal to height of water level, P is equal to water pressure, because here in opposite, here in this side water is storage and this water make a pressure on direction of water pressure and capital W is equal to self weight of dam and due to gravitational force it is act in down direction. R is equal to resultant force. This P water pressure and this weight of dam induce a resultant force R and this resultant force R cut the base. Okay, this resultant force R cut the base at point K. Small w is equal to density of water and it is given in kilonewton into meter cube, kilonewton per meter cube. And this density is the density of dam material that we use for construction. And unit of this density is equal to kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, here I take a one figure of dam. Okay, this is the pier section. Okay, we find out stresses in this pier section of dam. Okay, now again this is the hill level, the where the water is storage, that portion is known as our hill level and the front surface is known as our toe level. Okay, now one by one we find out a different value for dam and retaining wall. The difference between dam and retaining wall is that dam is stored the water and retaining wall is stored the soil. Only one difference is that here we find out water pressure in dam and retaining wall we find out soil pressure. Okay, now one by one here weight of dam we find out weight of dam, that means self weight of this dam is equal to capital W and A plus B capital H by 2 into density. A is equal to top width of dam, B is equal to bottom width of dam, H is equal to height of water level and this density is equal to density of dam material. Okay, and this is for 1 meter length. Okay, this is for 1 meter length pier section. Okay, inside section it will be constructed, it will be calculated for 1 meter length. Now second we find out total water pressure. water pressure of this water will be indicated by UVL, because when we go in depth, intensity of water is increased. So it is so by this diagram, this triangle, this is our UVL loading, uniformly varying loading with respect to height, it will be changed and depth it will be increased. Okay, now water pressure diagram is equal to P is equal to total water pressure 1/2 W H into H, because this load is changed with respect to height. So here is indicate with WH and it is equal to area of water pressure diagram, that means 1/2 area is equal to WH and height of this triangle is equal to H, 1/2 WH into H, that means water pressure P is equal to WH square by 2, where density of water is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube. Okay, if in data not given the value, then we assume that density of water is equal to 10 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, now we discuss for with this figure. In this figure, this CG is the center of gravity of this side section of pier and AJ is CG of this dam. Okay, AJ is CG of this dam and W is equal to our self-weight of dam, and here JK is the distance where resultant force R cut the base. Now next, B is our bottom width. Okay, one by one here we find out two values, that is weight of dam and second value is our total weight, total water pressure in dam. Now third, eccentricity E. For that, here I take a one figure again. This total water pressure P act horizontally from base H by 3. Okay, this water pressure P induce moment as a base from height H by 3, because here 2 cg, this is the triangle shape UDL, from this apex point cg is 2/3 into H, and from this base our cg is 1/3 of H. Okay, now this P induce moment with respect to this base, that is H by 3, and self weight of dam W is act in downward direction due to gravitational force. Now here we find out resultant force R. This resultant force R is under root of P square plus W square. Here we follow law of parallelogram, and here degree between this P and W is equal to 90. So under root of P square plus W square plus 2PQ cos theta, cos 90 is equal to 0. So here I write only P square plus W square. Okay, now this resultant force R cut the base at K point. Now we find out the value of JK. To find out value of JK, look at this, to find out value of JK, this P rotate clockwise direction and P to height of base is equal to H by 3, P into H by 3 clockwise, and this weight of dam rotate in anti-clockwise direction, W into distance JK, right here P into W into H by 3, and I simply here directly write down JK is equal to P by W into H by 3. Okay, now AJ here two summation of two sections. First one is our this rectangle section and second is our triangle section. Now combined CG of this trapezium is A square plus AB plus B square divided by 3 plus AB. Now next, after find out AJ and JK, we find out D. D is the summation of AJ plus JK. Look at this. D is the summation of AJ plus JK. Okay. Now next, eccentricity E find out. This base, this resultant force R cut the base at K point, and from this K point to up to the half of the width is equal to E. Now what is E? E is equal to D minus this half of the width B by 2, because our ultimate target is find out eccentricity and value of this eccentricity, then corresponding stresses we find out. Okay, because if value of eccentricity is positive, that means our given sigma maximum on this side, if our value of eccentricity is negative, then our given sigma max in opposite side. Okay, now next, find out maximum and minimum pressure or stresses for dam. sigma max is equal to capital W by B plus 1 plus 6 C by B. Then sigma minimum is equal to capital W by B 1 minus 6 E by B. Okay, take care, student are taking here density of water, but this is weight of dam, capital W. Okay, A plus B capital H by 2 into density. Here we take a weight of dam, not a density of water. Please take care. Now sigma minimum is equal to capital W by B 1 minus 6 E by B, where B is equal to bottom width of dam and E is equal to our eccentricity. Okay, this is the step for dam. Now we discuss for retaining wall. Okay, in retaining wall, the change will be dam store the water and retaining wall store the soil. Okay, one equation change, that is soil pressure. Okay, ultimate retaining wall is a structure which retain the soil. Okay, now figure is same. This is the figure of retaining wall. Look at this. This retaining wall are constructed and this retaining wall retain the soil. Okay, now again side section of dam and side section of retaining wall are same. A is equal to top width, B is equal to bottom width, H is equal to height of retaining wall, small h is equal to height of soil level. Okay, now here one thing change, that is WH into K. This load of soil is UVL, because again when we go down, density of soil is increased. So this is a UVL type of loading, and here load is given WH into K. The extra term here we use, that is KA, active earth pressure. Okay, now what is the equation of active earth pressure? Here we find out total earth pressure, or we can say that total soil pressure. P WH square by 2 into K, because WH square by 2, that means our area of soil pressure diagram, into we multiply with active earth pressure. Now what is active earth pressure? Is equal to 1 minus sin phi 1 plus sin phi. Okay, here it is the equation of active earth pressure. This KA we cancel here, because K value of K is equal to 1 minus sin phi 1 plus sin phi. Now what is KA? KA is equal to active pressure, that we already here write down, 1 minus sin phi 1 plus sin phi. What is phi? Phi is equal to angle of repose of soil, and earth pressure P is acting from H by 3, the base of retaining wall. Same that we already discussed in dam, the water pressure is act from base at height of H by 3. Okay, same soil pressure is act from base at height of H by 3. Okay, the only and only the difference of retaining wall is it retains soil and we find out soil pressure or earth pressure. And in equation, the term add, that is active earth pressure. And active earth pressure is depend upon angle of repose. Okay, now in today's session, we stop here. Okay, in today's session, we discuss for some point about dam and retaining wall. Now next session, we discuss for stability check. Okay, just now we stop here.